much. Round of applause for all those speakers who have come so far. Fabulous. What amazing stories. I don't know what to speak after this, but when Mr. Banerjee called me and said, you're going to speak on courage and what is the other thing of sparks? Heart. Courage is always about these stories, right? It's like, you know, path-breaking stuff, people who have gone beyond. So in my case, I was a little worried because as a stand-up comedian, you can make people laugh for 1 hour, but when you're told to give a speech and all, you realize that kuch courage wajah hai nahi tere mein. So what to say? For me, the changing point of many people ask me, you know, that how did you become a stand-up comedian after you did so much? By the way, first, before that, let's give a round of applause for Mary Kom. Yeah. I mean, this is one of the most fantastic achievements. I come from the sporting and sporting business, and for us, it is such a big thing. And I always believe that only women will win gold medals for India, without any doubt. It's only because Indian men are conditioned to get gold through dowry. They will never work hard. Indian men will win gold only when dowry is eradicated from the country. Anyway, so many people ask me that, you know, you're working in corporate life, and what was the game-changing moment, courage moment in your life that you became a stand-up comedian? You know, that time when I started stand-up comedy in 2002, there were no comedians, there was no place to perform your art. And for me, it was nothing to do with courage. It was to do with frustration. Because I was working as the vice president of a Sony company, and before that, just at MTV, we were having a dinner and a couple of drinks. Everybody was talking to event managers. And that day, I found out, that particular year, 2003, Yana Gupta had made more money than the chairman of Hindustan Levers and Procter & Gamble put together. And that completely destroyed me. I said, yaar, apan ne itna levers ka distribution system padha, ye kiya, wo kiya. That day I came back, mera Philip Kotler ko maine rakh diya. I said, boss, I want to become the item number in the world of cricket. Now, many people say ki thought out decision and all of that, nothing. I'll tell you one thing, that you will not learn anything from what I'm going to speak today. But you will understand broadly how this journey happened. And one of the things that I did for myself, and Mr. Banerjee used to teach us at the institute, is that I did something what they call now as self-introspection. And I realized that passionate and passion is an overrated word. Aisa kuch passion-vashan hota nahi hai 90% of the time. Because everybody says, you got to become passionate, you got to pick up. But I looked at myself, I'm not passionate about something. But you are forced to say ke boss passion dundo nahi hai boss. But then I introspected. I said, boss, apne mein passion nahi to kuch to hoga. Then I did an analysis. I think it was during the MBA time, and I realized that the only thing I enjoy doing is watch cricket. Now this cannot be a passion, right? Because 1.2 million people in India are doing it. But one thing was very clear, that boss heart was saying cricket. I met Harsha Bhogle at that time. He said, I'm passionate about broadcasting. I said, oh no. Ye bhi passion ki baat kar raha hai. But one thing I knew, I did not sit for any of these campus interviews because I knew that whatever profession I do, it has to entail watching cricket. So I came to Mumbai. I joined Sunil Gavaskar's professional management group. And he said, if he's Sunil Gavaskar's company, which means watching cricket. The other thing I was passionate about was doing time pass at Vaishali. We were in Pune at that point of time. And I said, profession has to be time pass. So these were the insights I was living with. I said that... And I said, something has to be around now, cricket pe charcha, something like that. So therefore I joined MTV because there it was all about, and that's the place where I realized that I was creative. Because MTV was a great environment during the times when, you know, this Liftman, Chai Wala and all these campaigns were starting, and I realized that boss, yahan pe cricket pe bhi baat hoti hai, music pe bhi baat hoti hai, and I realized I'm coming towards a zone which I want to be close to. And one of the reasons, and I think that is the most important thing, is that you need to have an objective in life. In my case, the objective was doing nothing, but still it was an objective. And that is something everybody needs to have. The second is, which I, you know, I don't know whether to say it because I don't think you'll learn much out of this, is that I never took myself seriously. And that is a fundamental thing that you need to crack in life. You should take your work seriously, you should not take yourself seriously. And I was never scared in college about kaun levers ja raha hai, kaun PNG ja raha hai, kaun Asian Paints. 5 years later when I started, 10 years later when I started my comedy, I used to do top management conferences for all these companies and tell them, tumne nahi recruit kiya na, main aa raha hu abhi. Because somewhere I knew I didn't want to join these guys. Because yahan pe time pass nahi hota hai. So, not taking yourself seriously, I thank God, him or her, jo bhi hai God. Two things. One is that I was not good looking. And second, I was not super intelligent. Because over a period of time, I've realized that people who are super intelligent and good looking have a problem later on in their life. I'll tell you why. Because you get success early in your life, na? Your expectations rise. And then you say that, ki boss, yaar, apne ko abhi 99.6, chal suicide. If you are mediocre 50%, which I was, the world was the oyster. And I realized very, in my management college, whatever course that I did, is that boss, 60 is rocking. Because 90% ka kya hai? Option medical, engineering. 60 means you can't go lower, na? And that's what opened my eyes. I did so many things. I did theater. I used to imitate cricketers on campus. And I realized that there is a world outside. So I'm not saying, I always tell my friends that, you know, who are parents, I said that, boss, apne aap 96 milna hai, to milne de. But nahi mil raha hai na, to usko sab karne de. Because somewhere lies your so-called passion. Unfortunately, because you are tempered to do only one or two, because at that time when we were in college, no, let's do medical because scope bahut hai. How can you do become a surgeon because scope is high? That's how we actually did that. And you know, in cricketing life, the one guy who gave me this clarity was Virendra Sehwag. I'll give you Sehwag's example as to many times over a period of 15 years I traveled with the Indian cricket team, and I realized that this guy is special because he exactly knows what his strengths are. And I realized it when a Ravi Shastri interview with Virendra Sehwag in Sri Lanka, you know, Ravi Shastri tried to complicate Sehwag's mind in English. So he said, Sehwag, the ball was coming on to the bat, not much grass on it. How did you gauge the bounce? What did Sehwag say? Aisi koi baat nahi hai, ball balle pe aa rahi thi, maine maar diya. This was a guy I like because his clarity was unbelievable. We were in England, and England, I think there was a time then Jimmy Anderson was bowling very well, and I went to his hotel room and Anderson bowling here, and then I said Viru, tu aise kaise khel raha hai yaar, first over mein tu maar raha hai. Sathe saab, England mein na har ball pe apna naam likha hota hai aur har ball pe naam likha uske pehle jitne run banane na bana le tu. Super clarity. Same next room you go to Dravid, he's super paralyzing, analyzing and stuff. Same with Sachin Tendulkar. But what Sehwag knew was, boss, main Dravid Tendulkar nahi hu. Main Virendra Sehwag hu. Meri aukat England mein 40 ball khelne ki hi hai. And that I think was amazing. And this happened to me when I was doing an interview of Virendra Sehwag. I told him, you know, Murli Tharan hai na? अगर थम दिख गया, सचिन पाजी ने मेरे को कहा है, अगर थम दिख गया तो आप मुरली को पकड़ सकते हो कि ये बट्टा मार रहा है, दूसरा मार रहा है. He said, यार मुरली ब्लैक, थम ब्लैक, मुझे तो कुछ दिखाई नहीं दिया. बट मैंने एक चाल चली. मैंने कहा मुरलीधरन को कि यार इस बंदे को हम समझ नहीं पाएंगे मगर उसको भी हम कंफ्यूज करेंगे. सो ही सेड एवरी टाइम मुरलीधरन बोल्ड आई डिड लाइक दिस एंड आई ट्राइड टू हिट हिम ऑन द ऑफ. सेड कोई भी बॉल डाल रहे तू. So Sachin came to me and he said that, yaar, why are you, he's bowling the other one, why are you hitting? Paji, aap chhod do. Jitna main usko off pe marunga na, utna wo dusra nahi dalega. That was Sehwag's theory. And when I told Sachin this, Sachin said that this theory you can't argue. So this is something which I realized, that everybody has a school of thought, that clarity is very important, and just in life you have to find your sehwag. Because at some point of time when I realized that, boss, the top two professions mein nahi aayega, so let's go and find out your calling, which is time pass and cricket. So at that point of time, it so happened, the only thing, so my, you know, I was bored of my job, the only thing that I knew is how to imitate Sachin Tendulkar. That was my skill. Imagine, this is what you are basing your entire career future on. But I said, chal back karte hain yaar isko. I quit my job. Again, very important, did not take myself seriously. The problem is ki tum log aisa judge, are wo iska ye six ye kar raha hai ye so 50 lakh kama raha hai. The moment you go into that zone, your career is gone. So I said, chalo, and that time every party and so many ad club events everywhere, I was waiting for people to tell me to imitate Sachin. And I used to do that in parties, and over a period of time I honed that skill. And you will not believe, the one important lesson in life that you have to learn is to make friends. You know, I was somebody who was just nice to people, because in my childhood people used to take my trip, and I realized I don't like conflict. So I don't say that I made friends because I wanted to. I was just happy seeing people happy. And when you try and do something unconventional in life, the only thing you require is people's support. And everybody, when I left my corporate job, came and said, chal, main terko show dilata hu. Leavers mein dost hai, haan, terko do show dilata hu. The whole world conspired for me to become a stand-up comedian only because I was nice to people. And I think that's one of the biggest lessons which I learned during my show, What the Duck, is that first season, from Sachin to Dravid to everybody, says, boss, you do the show and we'll support you. And to me, that is the most important thing. At the end of your career or whatever, 5 years from now, there are only two things I have learned. 5 good friendships and 5 good business deals. The earlier you do it, you'll go far. And if you don't crack friends in life, you'll never reach anywhere. But I'll show you what imitation got me to where I was. It was basically, everybody remembers the Sharjah moment, right? 1998, Sachin Tendulkar and Tony Gregg, the master of hype. My theory was, Sharad Pawar had paid Tony Gregg and said, the more you praise, the economy is dependent on Sachin Tendulkar, so keep shouting. Well, it's all happening here. Sachin Tendulkar's on fire. Smashed him all over the place. Boy, what a play. To the air, got him. Oh, that's a wonderful cricket. All those people are watching the telecast live on. Dude, Deshaun will be dancing in their lounges. He's the greatest batsman. Cut to. And then the interview happened. So Sachin Tendulkar, the ploy comfort level is of vital importance. These one day matches, I think you played some quality cricket out there.
Yeah, I thought most definitely, I thought the wicket was great. At the end of the day, what matters is that we play well as a team, and I thought we played better cricket than them. This is what got my career going.
2000 shows, corporate shows later, I think this is a good enough reason to continue the career further.